There's been a lot bandied about with respect to RFPs. The controller mistakenly, in many of his audits, took the position that there should have been RFPs for professional services. In those districts that I've represented, where I've responded to them, the controller acknowledges his mistake, but usually conveniently buries his acknowledgement in a footnote 35 pages back, where he says, although it's recognized that the law does not require it, it's a good idea. Now, your question is, why is it a good idea or why is it not a good idea? I think an RFP only becomes a vehicle for bringing people before the board for a choice of a selection, but it could be any other vehicle. And usually when a board or any client is dealing with professional services, whether it be an accountant, a lawyer, a doctor, or whatever, while price is one of the things you look at, of course, you're also looking at the quality of the services. And I'm not saying that this particular person's services were or were not up to quality. The only difference with respect to auditors, as I recall, and you can convict, 5 years, that's what I was going to say, that you, the state in its infinite post-Roslyn wisdom decided that you couldn't use the same auditor for more than 5 years. However you bring in other people to be considered by the board, it does not have to be an RFP. The law clearly does not require it.
All right, so now we understand the advantage to putting it out to RFP. What's the disadvantage?
Well, the disadvantage is I think that there is a mistaken belief that it's tantamount to, not by the board, not by the professionals, but sometimes by the public or the media, which sometimes has a mistaken belief or somehow understands it as a mistaken belief, but uses it to sell newspapers, that if you decide to select a professional whose cost is 36 cents an hour more, that somehow you've done something wrong. That's the only disadvantage, that the controller has created this false impression and the media has picked up on it.
Yeah.
All
right. But other than that, there's no disadvantage.
I'm inclined to suggest that we don't do it by way of RFP and that we exert our rights. I mean, that's my my opinion.
The controller does exactly what Al said.
He
admits in the education law you do not need it. But then he says in the municipal law,
Let me address the law.
Please.
Case law is crystal clear in this state for many, many decades, perhaps a century or more. The education law, what he's doing is he's picking and choosing. He acknowledges, if you look at the note that was attached to the last audit that was done, which he buried 37 pages back in response to the letter we sent him, he acknowledges that it's not required, but in his infinite estimate, it is somehow preferable. Frankly, this is the same office that has trouble managing a pension system. But in any event, they're out there with these political audits that we've finally gotten them to acknowledge, but they bury it, they hide it, because the bean counters that they send in are given a list of things to look for, and most of them are wrong. The answer is no, you don't have to do it. If you feel it's a preferable way, you can do it. And you can acknowledge you're doing it of your own free will, not because the controller says so, or you can use any other method. But I think you would want to bring in as many people to consider as you possibly could, so you can make a sound decision based upon the quality of services as well as the cost.
I'm looking at the RFP as just sending out a bureaucracy.
Well, it is.
And I'm opposed to that. I'm philosophical, honestly.
Frankly, it was the controller, and if I can add to it, editorial comment, the controller did not audit one school district from 1992 until Roslyn. So in order to cover his tail, Hevesy started, and of course he's residing somewhere at the expense of the state right now, he started making political hay out of it, attacking everybody. And it was picked up by the current incumbent. But this is what they do. Okay. This is politics.
Well, we could look at it as a form of advertising. Okay. Catherine, you have the first. I'll entertain a motion on items 1 through 4.